Hello, welcome to Latest Wealth. I'm Kailash. I'm a financial advisor as well as wealth coach. My dear friends, I have been conducting a lot of workshops and training classes and seminars. And recently when we were conducting in one workshop, people started asking, sir, which sector I have to invest? My dear friends, before becoming invested in stock market, first you should know about different sectors in stock market. Yes, my friends, when you have knowledge about different sectors, then you can use your logic, then only you can create magic in the stock market. Then you can do proper analysis. So in this way, we have been giving awareness for the people about different sectors. In this video, I'm going to share little bit knowledge about the construction sector. The construction about industrial infrastructure. My dear friends, you would have seen for last 30-40 years in India, what was your observation if I ask this question? And tell me, suppose, let me give an example. Long time back when you want to come from Bangalore to Hyderabad, it was taking almost more than 16 to 20 hours of journey by road. Now tell me, how much time is it taking? Even if you catch any bus also, just within 5 to 6 hours you can reach Hyderabad. The reason, you can say immediately, sir, the roads. Yes, same the way, like everywhere infrastructure development is keep on going. If you see any city or wherever you are staying in the same town also, how was the infrastructure long time back? Now how is the infrastructure? That means naturally infrastructure keep on developing. When the infrastructure develops, economy develops. When economy develops, country develops. And this is a cycle keep on going. For last 30 years you have been watching lot of infrastructure developments. All these comes under construction, infrastructure sector. Now let us go some more details. Let us go.
Construction, industrial and infrastructure. Sector group, capital goods. Classification, commodity business. India is on the verge of witnessing a sustained growth in infrastructure buildup. The construction industry has been witness to a strong growth wave powered by a large spend on housing, road, ports, water supply and airport development. The construction sector has registered double digit growth during the last few years, and its shares as a percentage of GDP has increased considerably as compared to the last decade. The Planning Commission of India has proposed an investment of around US $1 trillion in the 12th five-year plan 2012 to 2017, which is double of that in an 11th five-year plan. The industry has witnessed a considerable shift from traditional financing methods and limited debt support to an era of structured finance, private equity and public offering. The construction sector is a major employment driver, being the second largest employer in the country, next only to agriculture. This is because of the chain of backward and forward linkages that the sector has with other sectors of the economy. About 250 ancillary industries such as cement, steel, brick and timber and building material are dependent on the construction industry. A unit increase in expenditure in the sector has a multiplier effect and the capacity to generate income as high as 5 times. Past 4 to 5 years have seen a substantial increase in the number of contractors and builders, especially in the housing and road construction segment. The cumulative growth in the index of 8 core industries was 4.7% in 2017-18 and 4.3% year on the year in April 5, 2018-19. In the road sector, the government's policy to increase private sector participation has proved to be a boon for the infrastructure industry, with a large number of private players entering the business through the public-private partnership model. India is expected to become the third largest construction market globally by 2022. India has a requirement of investment worth 50 trillion in infrastructure by 2022 to have a sustainable development in the country. During December 2018, infrastructure sector witnessed PE by VC 12 deals worth 500 million and 8 US 1 billion plus deals. All villages in India will be connected through a road network by 2019 under Pradhan Mantri Gram Sadak Yojana. Road building in the India has become the second cheapest in Asia. In August 2017, a new metro rail policy was announced to boost private investment in the sector. The government is also working on improving energy infrastructure in the country, and investment opportunities worth US 300 billion will be available in the sector in the coming 10 years. According to Department for Promotion of Industry and Internal Trade, the infrastructure sector has become the biggest focus area of Government of India. Under Union Budget 2019-2020, US 63.20 billion was allocated to the sector from April 2002 to December 2018. Construction development sector received FDI inflows amounting to US$24.90 billion. Infrastructure activities sector received a US$24.91 billion. Demand exceeds supply by a large margin. Demand for quality infrastructure construction is mainly emanating from the housing, transportation and urban development segments.
Now let us see, what are the future prospects of this industry?
Future prospects in stock market. First one, domestic economic growth leading to huge growth in industrial and commercial activity, need for constructing industries and infrastructure to maintain the pace of growth. Next, rapid urbanization and industrialization of small towns and semi-urban areas. Huge requirement for infrastructure like roads, bridges, railways, airports, etc. And last one, government initiative and founding of infrastructure, especially through public-private participation models.
My dear friends, now let us see what are the advantages of this sector in Indian stock market.
Advantages this sector in stock market: use of world-class technologies with high degree of mechanization, and which had to lead a sea change in the quality of infrastructure available. Availability of skilled manpower to design, construct and maintain large projects even in remote areas. Availability of raw materials and tools for construction.
Now you heard about all the advantages. You might be thinking, Kailash, only plus points? There are no minus points. Yes, my friends, as an investor, you should know about plus points as well as minus points. Strengths and weakness. You should know about disadvantages of this sector. Now let us have a look about what are the disadvantages of this sector.
Disadvantages for this sector in stock market: shortage of clear title land and huge land acquisition hurdles, impacted negatively by high interest rates and raw material price volatility, corruption of public officials, uncertain and changing government's policies and tax structure, shortage of unskilled manpower, especially after the implementation of social welfare programs like NREGA, low for road and housing construction. However, high working capital requirements can create growth problems for companies with weak financial muscle. Very high across segments like road construction, housing and urban infrastructure development. Relatively less in airport and port development areas.
My dear friends, when you are investing in stock market about this sector, what are the important indicators you have to observe? Now you might have got some idea. Now let us see who are the key players in this sector.
Key player companies in stock market: Larsen and Toubro, Jay Prakash Associates, Gaman India, Panji Lloyd, Lanco Infra and Hindustan Construction Co.
My dear friends, hope you got some knowledge about this particular sector, and please keep on doing own research. And hope you enjoyed the session. Please share with your friends and subscribe to this channel. If you are not subscribed, please subscribe and press the bell icon so that whenever we are uploading new videos, immediately you will get the information. And in future, we are going to create some more videos on different sectors so that one day you will become master in investing. And thank you for watching. Till we meet again, enjoy every bit of life. Have a nice day and bye bye. Thank you very much.